Hi everyone, today I am here with the topic delegation of authority, centralization of authority and decentralization of authority. This delegation of authority and centralization of authority becomes very important when the organization starts growing in size or the size of the organization expand and the manager himself cannot do entire work on his own. He has to take the help of his subordinate. He has to share his work and authority with the subordinate. So here comes the importance of delegation of authority or decentralization of authority. Now what is delegation of authority? Delegation of authority means transfer of authority from the superior to his subordinate along with responsibility to get the assigned work done. That's what delegation of authority. Delegation of authority means transferring the authority, that means decision taking power to the subordinate. Okay? So when there is delegation of authority, the superior will assign the task. So first there will be assignment of task. Task will be assigned to the subordinate. After giving task to the subordinate will get the authority. Authority given. Now what is authority? Authority is decision taking power. The superior gives permission to the subordinate to use certain rights. The rights of spending money, the right to command or provide instruction to the other people to do the work, or the right to use resources of an organization, or the right to represent the company. The certain rights will be enjoyed by the subordinate. Now, without the authority, the assigned task cannot be performed. That cannot be done. So after that, we have the responsibility. So when there is delegation of authority, with the delegation of authority, responsibility comes. So what is the responsibility? The obligation to perform the work satisfactorily. So when the task is assigned and authority is given, it is the obligation of the subordinate to perform the task satisfactorily or to get the work done satisfactorily. So that is what the delegation of authority. And delegation of authority takes place from one superior to one subordinate. Right? Then comes to the authority. Then comes to the centralization of authority. Centralization of authority means decision making power in few hands. Or concentration of decision making power at one point in an organization. That means all the decisions will be taken at one particular point. Nobody is given right to take decision. Right? All the decisions are taken by the board of directors. No powers are given to the middle level managers or the lower level managers. Everything rests with the board of directors. All the decisions will be taken at one particular point. That is called centralization of authority. Then we come to the decentralization of authority. Now what is decentralization of authority? Transfer of decision making power or authority from the superior to all the people right down to the lowest unit throughout the organization. That means your decision-making power does not get transferred from one superior to one subordinate. Rather, it gets transferred to all the levels in an organization. Like here, you have three levels in an organization. This is top level, this is middle level, and this is the lowest level. So all the people down these levels get the power to take a decision. All the managers will get the power to take the decision at their own level. Like production manager will get the power to take a decision regarding his department. production department. All the decisions will be taken by each of the managers here, right? So that is decentralization of authority. But decentralization of authority does not mean that entire decision taking power is distributed to the lower level in the organization or distributed to all the levels in an organization. The major decision taking power will stay centralized. Right? So major decision taking power will still remain with the center or will remain at one particular point, and other powers will be given out to the middle level or lower level managers. That is called decentralization of authority. Importance, or you can say the merits here. Number one, it removes burden. It removes a burden from the superior. Why? Because the superior delegates some of his work or the authority to the subordinate. So he is freed from anxiety or tension, and he can employ or use his time for policy making decision or strategic decision. Number two, leads to specialization. Leads to specialization. Why? Here the superior delegates or assigns task to his subordinate according to his skill and ability. So that is what? Division of labor, division of work. And this division of work or assigning the task to the subordinates as per their skills or ability will lead to better utilization of resources, both human as well as non-human. So delegation of authority or decentralization of authority are both a good way of motivating the employees or the subordinate. Why? Because delegation of authority provides what? A status, a feeling of recognition, because they are given the task of getting the work done with other people. So they can use their own judgment. They can use their skill in a better way. And if the task is done satisfactorily, they become more than happy and feel satisfied, and that will help them motivated to do better for the organization. Personal development. Personal development. So again, delegation of authority or decentralization of authority helps the subordinate or the lower level managers to develop their personal skill or decision making or decision taking skills, because they are allowed or they are given permission to use certain rights, like taking decision of spending money, right? So they get an opportunity to improve on their skills. Okay, so this leads to personal development, or this leads to making of future managers. So then, what is the difference between delegation of authority and decentralization of authority? So I'll tell you the one major difference. This delegation of authority takes place from one superior to one subordinate. But again, decentralization of authority is also delegation of authority or decision making power. But here, the power gets transferred from the superior to all the people in an organization. That means it is not restricted to one subordinate or two subordinates. Rather, here that decision-making power is given to the managers at all the level in an organization. Right? Thank you.